Monsieur, you'd think that St. Lucians had never before seen a set of totots. What's all the fuss about? Whether deliberately exposed or the result of a wardrobe malfunction, should we really have spent so much time on the issue? I think not. Lady, whoever you are, you did nothing wrong. You have nothing to be embarrassed about. I'm sure, though, that you and many others like yourself would have learned a valuable lesson. Next time you collect your carnival costume, make sure that it fits right and can stand a vigorous shake-up. So some of you did not like the look of the totots. Seriously? Was it the complexion? You don't like dark nipples? You prefer the red ones? Not on a dark woman, surely not. And do you know how many women would pay out loads of money to have breasts that stand in that position? Better the totots jump out the top of the bra than they fall out of the bottom. Girlfriend, you can enter a wet t-shirt competition any day and win a prize. You'd need a little more totots to win the first prize, though. As for those of you who vex about the exposure, whom exactly are you vexed with? The Star newspaper gave you, not news, but the entertainment that you crave, and the rag sold. The girl ought really to demand royalties from the Star, but then she would have to bare those breasts again to prove that the object of so much attention are uniquely her own. Better leave that alone. If she made the demand, the Star would find another story in that to make more money off the issue. And why is it that Mr. Red is getting all this attention? For doing successfully what everybody else is doing or trying to do. Thaddeus ought not to waste time and effort responding to those criticisms. Bro, you've done well. Kudos to you. I know what it is to put a carnival band on the road. But most St. Lucians would not have a clue what's involved. The long hours, the stress, the cost, and therefore it is easy for them to talk. Personally, I doubt that you are making money off of this. Certainly not enough for the time and effort involved. But if you are, all power to you. And you are giving to people what they demand. I know that if there was a section for ghosts, and the option for the costume was white body paint or a white sheet, there would be one person in a white sheet to every 9 in white body paint. The most important feature of the band is numbers. If you can't get people to join because they don't like the costumes, you'd eventually have to get out of the business. And the so-called traditional bands know this all too well, and they have all conformed. For the sake of culture, my foot. Those who wish to participate in something cultural should join a Laros or a Marguerite group, learn the quadrille or learn to play the violin or the drums. Carnival now has nothing to do with who we were in the past. It has evolved as we have. And it is too late now to be concerned about the culture and the morality of carnival. When the decision was made to change the festival from February to July, somebody on that decision-making body ought to have given some thought to the true meaning of carnival as opposed to the economic benefits of the festival. That failure, I think, was an oversight and has greatly assisted in this Christian population straying even further from traditional moral values. In these times when the church has lost its influence on the citizen and religion and spirituality has lost its significance, particularly on our younger persons, I believe the question to be clothed or not to be clothed is a non-issue. Carnival is originally a pagan festival related to much feasting and merrymaking. It was adopted by the Catholic Church as a day of feasting before the total fast of Lent. The festival was held on Shove Tuesday, the day before Ash Wednesday, the beginning of Lent. Mardi Gras, or Fat Tuesday, as it was also called, had a very special significance. It was a day of indulgence. Everyone was expected, however, from the first day of Lent until Easter Sunday, 40 days hence, to fast and to pray, to deny body and mind the pleasures of moral existence. Meat, sweets, alcohol, parties, and all personal vices, including, of course, sex, whether in thought or in deed. Somewhere along the way, however, things changed, as invariably they will. One day of indulgence was deemed insufficient to make up for 40 days of fasting. Carnival, therefore, became a season of indulgence, of parties, of music, of costumes, of parades and dancing. New Orleans and Rio, Brazil, are the biggest such festivals. And for the West Indian portion of planet Earth, beginning in Trinidad, we have added to the festival whining, steel band, calypso, and lots of alcohol. And as time has passed, carnival in this new world and in this modern thinking has lost its religious significance. As a consequence, Lent too has lost its meaning. As a Christian community, we no longer have a time of year for collective introspection, to look at ourselves in the mirror and to take stock of who we are and where we want to be as a people. From January 1st to December 31st, it is just one long carnival bacchanal. I think that we have so much more to be concerned about than a pair of bare breasts, really. We celebrate, hurt it, when we propose non-violence. I don't get it. For commentary, I am Lorraine Deborah Glass.